shopping.
Resting bitch face. Oh, come on. We got cheesecake to make.
That's a stop sign.
Heck, I ain't got time for no stop sign.
Hi guys, my name's Holly Baxter. I'm an accredited practicing dietitian and online physique coach, and today I'm going to be making a peanut butter and Oreo cheesecake slice. So I'm going to break down for you the ingredients by layer. So this is a 4-layer cake. It's pretty awesome. So I'm going to start with the base. You're going to need some kind of lower calorie butter. I'm using the I Can't Believe It's Not Butter, just because it is probably one of the lower fat butter products on the market. That's for US. I haven't seen anything quite this low in Australia, but there are some similar brands. You're also going to need some kind of Oreo biscuit. So this is for the base. Now, these aren't gluten-free. I'm celiac, so I won't be able to eat this lovely dessert, which is kind of sad, but I couldn't find the gluten-free ones in the store today. But this can be a gluten-free recipe if you use gluten-free Oreo biscuits. In the base, you're also going to need some kind of sweetener. You can use liquid or you can use powder. I'm using powder today. For the second layer is our peanut butter layer. So this is the thickest, most delicious part of this whole cake. I love it. So I'm going to be using this fat-free ricotta cheese, which I spoke about earlier, for the reason that I'm trying to keep the calories lower. So instead of using regular cream cheese or some kind of Philly cheese, this is a fantastic substitute. And to hold it all together, I'm going to have to use some gelatine. So gelatine in the middle layer. And then obviously for the peanut butter flavor, I'm going to be using my favorite nuts and more. If you guys haven't tried nuts and more, please go and take a look at their Instagram pages and their websites. They have so many awesome flavors. They're higher in protein than regular peanut butter spreads. They also have almond spreads. And today I'm using birthday cake. It's so good. And to continue adding more peanut butter flavor, but without the extra calories, I'm going to be using a powdered peanut butter. So for the third layer, which is kind of like the Cool Whip layer, I'm going to be using this Publix fat-free Cool Whip, and I'm going to mix a little bit of chocolate powder into here to give it a nice chocolatey flavor, as well as this chocolate pudding. So this is a calorie or a low calorie chocolate dessert. You can get these in your supermarkets. This particular product only has 7 grams of carbohydrate per serve, whereas regular puddings would be much higher in carbohydrate. So I'm going to mix that together to make my third layer. And then on top to finish it off, we're going to top with some Reese's peanut butter cups or pieces and some of these miniatures. Along with some little mini Oreos. So you can decorate your cake with whatever chocolates you like, but I'm going for Reese's because it kind of goes with that peanut butter feel. We're gonna need a couple of spoons, a spatula, because we're using a food processor today, so this will come in handy. Definitely have out a mixing bowl and a smaller bowl so that you can actually mix your gelatine. You're gonna need a full cup, a half cup, a set of scales, and also a food processor to blend the ingredients. So you're gonna need to set your oven at around 360 degrees Fahrenheit, and I'll be baking this for about 40 minutes. You need the entire packet of Oreo biscuits for your cheesecake-based slice. You're going to need 75 grams of butter, a full cup of stevia sweetener if you're using powder, or an equivalent amount if you're using the liquid stevia or some kind of sweetener. So I'm going to put that all straight into the food processor, unblend it, and then I'm going to set it into a tin and bake it for about 15 minutes. I'm going to take two of these and sit them over with the toppings because it's going to look cool for a bit of color contrast when I finish. And also to give the base its chocolate coloring, I'm just going to put a heaped tablespoon of cocoa powder as well. 75 grams of butter, and I'm going to put that straight into the base. I'm going to take one of these baking trays right now, and I'm going to give it a light spray with some kind of cooking grease or butter spray, and then I'm going to take the base and push it down so that we've got a nice flat finish. I'm going to use the spatula because it will help to smooth things out. base out of the oven. So it's been in there for about 15 minutes. And we're just going to allow that to set and cool so that we can put our next layer on. So I'm going to put that into the freezer just to speed up the processing time. Okay, so I'm going to start layer two now. So this is the peanut butter, the thick peanut butter layer that's next. So you're going to take the entire tub, so almost a kilo of this light or no-fat ricotta cheese, whatever you have access to. Full tub of this, which is a kilo. We're going to take half a cup of the nuts and more peanut butter. I would love to use more, but keep in mind I am trying to make this a lower calorie alternative to what would normally be for a cheesecake slice. So half a cup only of this, and then I'm going to make up the rest of that peanut butter flavor by adding in half a cup of this peanut butter powder, okay? The final two ingredients for the peanut butter layer are going to be the stevia or the sweetener. I'm going to use a whole cup of this, and then I'm going to be using the gelatine. Two sachets, because we're using quite a bit of cheesecake, quite a bit of ricotta cheese, so we're gonna need something to really hold and bind and stabilize that middle layer. Is that Kabira?
Oh my god.
Yum! So I'm going to take this and I'm going to put this back in the freezer just to help encourage the cheesecake to set, and then I'm going to make the third layer. You notice I'm not bothering to wipe down the food processor. If you wash this every single time, you're probably going to add 30 minutes to your cooking time, so I'm not going to do that today. Taking the fat-free whip or Cool Whip, and I'm going to put that straight into the food processor. I'm going to take the pudding mixture. I'm going to use two servings of this, so it's about half of the sachet, and I'm going to mix a tiny little bit of water in with this to help it form. I'm then going to take one heaped tablespoon of the Hershey's for some extra chocolatey flavor. Put it into the freezer and wait for the cake to actually chill a little bit. So I'm gonna wait about 30 minutes and then I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna layer this over the top, and that's gonna be layer number three. Okay, so I've just brought this out of the freezer and it's been in there for about 30 minutes. We're just gonna take the last layer and string that over the top. Now with the toppings, I would definitely recommend putting these in the fridge beforehand, because then they're easy to cut. Like these ones. So we're gonna need 45 grams of the Reese's peanut butter chips. Let's go ahead and sprinkle those on the top. So it's been a few hours. I've been away and trained. I'm sweaty mess, but I'm excited because I get to come home to this amazing Oreo peanut butter cheesecake featuring the nuts and more peanut butter. Thanks very much for watching. If you like this, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you like my recipes, share it. And if you would like some more information about nutrition coaching, please head to my website. It's www.hbnutrition.com.au. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great day.
Intro.
Hi guys, my name's Holly Baxter. Delete it before you even start.
More of the skin.
Why did I put peanut butter in the beginning? That was a bad idea. But awesome for the toppings.
Oh my god. Can you explain that? Is that part of the recipe?
Spoon this. Ow. I swear I don't speed.
It's a stop sign.